Parliament's back tomorrow. You'd expect a big focus on the migration debate in the wake of the budget week. That was one of the key themes.
So both sides think they have ammunition. The opposition's probably got the better ammunition. Let's face it, that's a migration detainee scandal. The government believes that there's some holes in the opposition's promise to cut net migration, but the opposition will think, well, we're on a winner saying we're doing it, no matter what the exact numbers were. It is unclear. I mean, we revealed here that it was a cut net migration to 160,000. Peter Dutton, the day after his budget reply speech, confirmed that for the first year. That's from 260,000. And in his budget reply speech, he talked about the cut in permanent migration by 25%. But we haven't seen a policy document. We didn't even see a press release outlining these numbers. And that's why there's still a bit of confusion with them, which I still think exists after the Shadow Treasurer's appearance on the program yesterday.
Peter Dutton has already talked about that first year where we'd see a reduction of around 37% in the NOM, as it's called, the net overseas migration, and then that would move to the 25% reduction, the quarter below where it is today.
160,000 the first year. What does it uptick to the second year? Roughly.
Well, Andrew, I've just been through the numbers. 37% in the first year, moving to 25% and somewhere in the middle in the second year. And that is the pathway to making sure that we get that balance right between immigration and housing.
Mr. Taylor, has the opposition done any sort of numbers on what the policy to cut net migration by 100,000 a year would cost the budget and the economy?
All the work we do, all the policies we announce, we put through the PBO and we work through that with them very closely, and we will continue to. We're confident that the package of policies that we announced on budget and reply night is revenue neutral. It's going to be positive for the budget.
How can it be revenue neutral when you're cutting 100,000 from the net migration? Can you explain that to me?
Different immigrants have different impacts on the budget. And this is a very, very important point. We have said that we're getting the refugee and humanitarian intake back to the levels they were at under the previous government, and that's appropriate.
So it's a big cut they're talking about to the refugee program, but still, if you just cut by 37% the net migration in this country and you're saying it's revenue neutral, I don't know about that. I do think tomorrow question time, it's going to be pretty heated. Things are ramping up. We're well and truly in that pre-election period now, Kieran, and I think you've made this point before that the PM saying he's going full term, but when is full term? Is the end of this year still sort of near enough the election timing to be full term, or early next year even before the WA election? I think the election timing is far from settled.
Yeah, indeed, Andrew. I think couldn't agree more with you on that. Thanks. We'll talk to you soon.